Good Saturday morning, sports fans. It is a beautiful Saturday morning here and a beautiful Saturday morning for sports. I'm Cameron Kurtz, joined always by Josh Komnick. You're in the cheap seats here on WLCN Radio 96.3, today's best country. We are out here at Graue Incorporated on Kickapoo Street in Lincoln. And Josh, our second show that we have out here, and we'd like to thank the folks out at Graue for having us out here today.
Yeah, it's a definitely, like you said, a beautiful day, a good day for sports. A lot of local stuff, especially here in Lincoln, Illinois, going on today, softball, baseball, that kind of thing. And especially out here at Graue, looking at the inventory, a lot of beautiful cars. I see one straight ahead that I'd like to have, a nice Corvette sitting out there. It'd be a nice day for that baby out on the road.
It would be a nice day. And what's also nice about that Corvette, it says Josh Conley.
Yeah.
I mean, it really does. Not too many vehicles can say that, but
yeah.
I believe that one does. Josh, we're going to kind of switch gears a little bit and turn to another side of sports that a lot of people, you know, think about, but then at the same time, a lot of people probably forget about, and that's the area of officiating.
Yeah, it's a sometimes not the the thankless job, I know, but, you know, I know the guys that do it get a lot of satisfaction. The fans sometimes are mixed. Players are mixed anymore. But, you know, those guys do a very tough job, especially in today's game, where whether it be basketball, baseball, volleyball, the athletes are getting so much bigger, stronger, faster, that it's a tough job out there. And I don't think they probably get as much credit as they do deserve, because obviously, you know, we wouldn't have sports without somebody officiating or abiding by the rules. And that's what exactly this guy next to you has done for a very long time.
And of course, that guy that he is talking about, longtime basketball official, Mark Newhouse. Mark, thanks for being here with us today.
I'm glad to be here.
All right. You know, Mark, a lot of people are probably wondering, when it comes to officiating, and a lot of times when you say a referee, first thing that pops into somebody's mind is probably a basketball referee or a football referee. How is it that one becomes an official, and the different levels of officiating that are out there?
Well, when I started, which was 35 years ago, Cameron.
They're a little different than now, maybe. A
lot different. I started out with Tom Zurkhammer, Wayne Lally, and Ace Hinman. I know Josh remembers Ace.
Mm-hmm.
They're the ones that began me in my career, and they started me out in the rec league, and that was nothing but a brutal bloodbath. So I learned a lot there. And then I advanced to start doing junior high basketball, the Illinois Elementary Association, and from there I went up to the High School Association. So you have to pay your price to move up.
What about some of the training that you have to go through? I know you attend a lot of camps and clinics throughout the year. I mean, is that something that you have to do annually, or can you kind of do it you know, when you want? How does that work?
For the high school, we're required to go every 3 years and get a clinic called Certification Clinic, and that's usually, we go out here with Ricky Holmes, who's the assigner of the Central State A Conference, so we can just pick that up right here in Lincoln, Illinois. That is required by the IHSA. But for college, which I also work for conferences, that's a requirement every summer that we go to a clinic so they can see us work, see if we need things that we need to work on. So you're busy the year round when you're a basketball official.
And when you talk about somebody telling you that you need to maybe work on your calling, your hand signals, that kind of thing, does somebody come out and watch you during the year, Mark, where you have, you know, you're at Springfield High School doing Springfield and Griffin game? Will you have a representative from Illinois High School Association coming out and watching you, or one of the college games that you do? Are you always being examined on how well that you're displaying what you're supposed to be doing?
For high school, like I said before, Josh, the Central State 8, the assigners, Ricky Holmes, he tries to get out and see us work. And the Big 12 Conference, which I work for, Roger Quinlan, he pretty well trusts us because he works college ball with us, so he knows that we can officiate basketball game. Mr. Gibson from the IHSA, he will make an appearance. We never know when he's there. He doesn't really come in and speak to us. He might send us an email or something. But for the most part, someone's there to observe you.
Sure.
I understand there's a lot of testing that, you know, that an official needs to go through before he or she can actually put on the stripes and get out on the court. How often do you have to go through that testing, and what is it that you have to do to score on that test to keep your license from year to year?
Okay. You are required each year to take Part 1 exam, and this is new now. It's all online. There's no more, used to be able to take a written test, send it in, but now it's all going to be online. That's required every year. You have to get 80% of that correct. If you don't, you can take it again. You pay the IHSA again, another total.
They just want that some more money.
They just want more money. As far as Part 2 exam, if you want to go, you start out in basketball. You start out as a registered official, and then after you work so many years, you can advance to what we call recognized. And the highest you go in basketball is certified, and that's as high as you can go in the high school ranks.
Okay, so you're talking about when an official goes from promotion, let's say you have an official who's at the registered level and he wants to move up to the recognized level, move up to that next, you know, plateau of officiating, get himself a little bit more games. How does he go through about, you know, the promotion process? Does he have to take another test? Does he need recommendations? How does that work?
All right, he does need recommendations, which, you know, Cameron, you asked me to write you a little letter to the IHSA last year.
Very nice letter at that, thank you.
Which I did, and you have to get so many recognitions from officials who are certified, as well as an AD or a coach, and then you have to take the Part 2 exam, which is, I believe now it's closed book, isn't it, Cameron? When I took it, it was still an open book.
But, no, it's closed book.
Okay,
now.
And you have to advance on that, and that's how you move up your levels in high school basketball.
Mark, you talked about some guys that were around this area that got you going. At what point did you become saying, hey, I'm going to do this for 35 years? Did Mr. Hinman or Mr. Zurkhammer say, you know, you've done well here, why don't you keep going with it? Or was it something that you just thoroughly enjoyed to do and you've now, you know, kept on doing it for 35 and it sounds like you're going to keep going for a while?
You know, that's a good question, Josh. When I started out, you know, I took the booze and everything from people, and I still do, but you just learn to tune that out. It's became a love of my life. I mean, since I retired from the Department of Corrections, I either officiate high school basketball games or a junior high game if I'm open, mm-hmm. or usually there's a college game that I'm going to work, because I work 4 different conferences in college ball. And, it, you know, at the same time, I'm giving back to the community. I enjoy doing what I do. It keeps me physically fit. So, you know, it's a reward for me.
Sure.